Hello guys, welcome to Bridge Channel. Today I'm going to explain about my Shadow Chaser build. So I hope this video can help you to improve your build and make your own Shadow Chaser. First, let me explain about my PvP build first, okay? So for PvP build, I usually just use the Shadow or Shadow Lurker build or the MVP build. For the stat, I'm going for the STR 99 on strength and just enough agility to make my attack speed 500, and the rest of the status point I will just put it on my luck. Okay, for the skill preset for this Phantom build or Shadow MVP build, as you can see, 10 on double attack, 10 on increased dodge, 4 on shield dodge, 5 on envenom, 10 on hiding, and 1 point on backslide. On second job, just put 10 on riding strike, 5 on snatcher, 5 on compulsory discount, and 5 on stealthy, and 5 point on rampage. On trend second job, put 10 point on backstab, 5 on shadow seeker, 3 point on remove armor, 3 point on remove weapon, 5 point on counter instinct blade, and 5 point on surprise attack. Also, don't forget to put 5 point on slyness and 3 point on copy. Rest 1 point, just put it on gravity. Okay, for the third job on this PvP Phantom build, just put 3 point on technic acquiring, 10 point on soul capturing, 10 on auto shadow spell, 3 point on strip, 10 point on shadow slash, 1 on gravity mastery, and 3 point on emergency escape. For the MVP skill that I use on PvP, it depends on my target, or is it single target or I have mass PvP. For single target, I usually use this multiple force spear from Stormy Knight MVP and Spirit Ambush from Deviling. Also for support, usually I'm using Power Boost or Assume. The one skill that I use from copy or plagiarism is True Strike from the MVP Parao, and just put it auto like this. So first is the multiple frost spear, second is spirit ambush, and after that just put the triangle slot and put the auto shadow spell and 2 buff that we have for boost and true sight. When I going for mass PvP, I will switch my MVP skill to Meteor Assault and also Spirit Ambush, but the buff I will change it to Assume Teo to increase my defense and M defense. You can see, just switch the multiple frost spear to meteor assault and then put Assume on your auto. Next, for my equipment, on my divine armament, I use the soul capture divine armament on my weapon, and for the armor, I'm using the Carstone superior craftsmanship. On my accessory, Radiant Ornament, I'm using Double Chaos on both necklace and the ring. After that, for my fair score, first one that I use is Core Overload and Shadow of Soul to increase the Counter Instinct duration. The second one is Holy Light Shield and Consulted to give me 15% more damage on my critical damage for 7 seconds after lose my invisibility. And the last one, I'm using the Mana Length Reversal and Malice to give me a chance to inflict status effect on my target. Okay. For my sync on my costume, for headwear, I'm using the Cherry Pie. For modwear, I'm using Musical Note. For the modwear, I'm using the Puppeteer modwear. And for backwear, I'm using the new backwear from Sky City. From the Runopoly that currently going. Or I can also use the bunny backwear. For the costume, I'm using the between the pop star or back to school costume. If you don't have back to school, you can use pop star. If you don't have pop star, you can use the bunny sheriff or even the Christmas. Just use any costume that can give you extra damage or P damage to inflict more damage. Okay, that's for the costume. Next, for my enchantment, I'm using the triple superior crit on my weapon and both of my accessory. So 3 superior crit and try to get like strength on every stat, top stat you can have. Next, for my Nebula pet, I'm using the Shadow Chaser Shadow Lurker Nebula pet with this setup on my Nebula pet. You can just copy it and you can just improve or use whatever you need on your Nebula pet. But remember, I will choose the Shadow Lurker on your Astral Sign or Ymirtir. Next one, for Sigil. For me, the job Sigil that I'm use is Power Concentration, because I think both Sigil is right now have 0 benefits on our third job skill, but it at least can give me or give Shadow Chaser character extra crit. Okay, and the rest of it, I'm using the Fearless, Impale, Cosmic, and also the Floating Protection. For Feather, I'm using the standard build that I usually use, the 4 gold and 1 purple with All Truth on my purple. And for the Moon equipment, just use Blitz, Resolute, Wuthering, and Perception. Okay. That next on my Nexus, the talent that you need on this Phantom build is Soul Capturing, Technic Acquiring. You can use Valorous or you can use the another talent that can give you extra damage like Ruthless or maybe a Bless to give you more stat. After that, you can also grab Gravity Mastery to increase your movement speed and damage reduction after using Gravity. Or you can also get the Strip to increase your success rate on removing equipment. Okay. I think that's it for the PvP build. Now I'm gonna explain about my PvE build. For my PvE build, I'm not using Phantom build, but I'm using the mask build. So for PvE, as you can see, this is my stat. So same goes max on a strength, enough agility to get 500 point attack speed, and the rest of it just put it on dex or luck. For me, I'm putting extra point on dex because the divine armament that I'm using on this PvE build. For skill, you can just copy it. So 10 on double attack, 10 on increased dodge, 10 on hiding, 1 on backslide, 5 on venom, 4 on shield dodge. After that, 10 on riding strike, 10 on crossbow mastery, 5 on snatcher, 5 on compulsory discount, 5 on stealth, and 5 on rampage. After that, on 32nd job, get 10 level on backstab, 5 on counter instinct, 3 point on remove armor and remove weapon, 5 point on shadow seeker, 3 point on copy, and 5 point on slyless. The extra 1 point, just put it on gravity. Okay, for the third job on this max PvE build, put 1 on deadly infect, 1 on fatal menace, 3 on strip, 5 on shadow impact, 5 on agony spread, 5 on invisibility, and get all the masquerade. Also get 1 point on gravity mastery and 3 point on emergency escape. Also don't forget to get our main DPS skill, the shadow slash. For auto skill, just put the shadow impact, shadow slash, or triangle shot. Also one masquerade of your choice. For me, I will just use the masquerade of unlucky. Okay, for the equipment, divine armament on this match PvE build is obsidian crossbow blade. See, on this obsidian crossbow blade, you need strength and dex to increase your P attack. That's why I'm put some point on my dexterity. On armor, just use Carsten superior craftsmanship. Okay, after that, for my radiant ornament on my accessory, just use double chaos. And for my sink, I'm using the teacup to get extra boss damage. On my face wear, I'm using the ocean imprint to give me more critical damage. On my mod wear, I will just use this cookie to get my extra damage against boss. On my backwear, I'm using the Christmas to get more critical damage. Also, the last one is for my costume, I'm using back to school. Okay, for the cogwheel, same goes for PvE and PvP. So core overload, shadow of soul, holy light shield, concealed teeth, mana length reversal, and malice. Okay. Next, for the enchantment, missing same triple superior crit on my weapon, my accessory, and also my second accessory. So 3 superior crit on my enchant. The rest of it just standard PvE enchantment. For Nebula Pet, on this PvE build, first you need to choose the Shadow Chaser Masquerade Magician on your Nebula Pet. And for the Nebula that you want to use, you can just copy mine, or you can just put it on whatever Nebula Pet that you need. For me, I will just use it like this on my PVE bill. Next, for the sigil tablet, sometimes I'm using the damage build, so just use Impel Cosmic and then use Berserk, or and also you can use the Choice Fate, or if you don't have, just use whatever sigil that can increase your damage and also your survival ability to own PvE. For the feeder, still same reset, so 4 gold and 1 purple. For mon equipment, I'm using the windbreaker on my dexterity branding, so I can get more PvE, melee PD damage and also P attack. The rest of it, you can just use whatever you have. Okay, for the Phantom, for the this mask Nexus engine, the talent that you need is one Gravity Mastery. Second one is you can use Valorous or Ruthless. The third one is Invisibility and Trip. Also, the last one is Fatal Menace. Okay, I will show you how the DPS on my PvE build against MVP. So we will just fight Uaya, large dragon. That's water dragon. And use converter to deal more damage on this build, and just use auto. You can use whatever weapon type. You can use bow or you can use the dagger. The DPS is still good. As you can see, the DPS goes high to 4 to 5 billion damage per second. The auto skill is just like this. Shadow Impact, the Shadow Slash or Triple Slot, and also one mass curate of your choice. I'm using the unlucky one, just like this. The DPS is 5,500 million damage per second. Okay, last but not least, I will show you how to grinding using this build. For grinding, just use Penta build and use MVP skill to grind. So I'm usually just use Meteor Salt to grind and also use bow type. Just switch your weapon to bow and put Meteor Salt on auto and triple slot. Let's try to find the grinding spot, maybe on this magma dungeon. The Meteor Salt AoE is really huge, so it can cover really large area. You just need to find the perfect spot to grind. Wait. I usually use this spot here where there's like some ads that spawn close to each other, just like this. Just grinding like this. Hope this guide video can help you to understand and build your own shadow chaser. If you have any question, just put it on the comment. So don't forget to subscribe and give like on this video. See you on next video. Thank you. Bye bye.